got something for you. I got some keys right here.
I got a car. Wilson, quick throw. And it's
good.
Intercepted. Intercepted by Malcolm Butler.
When the Patriots won Super Bowl 49, Tom Brady was happy. How happy? As the game's MVP, he was awarded a free car and promptly gave it to the teammate he felt most deserving.
You know, not too many quarterbacks would do what Brady did, so it just shows the kind of guy he is, the kind of character he has. Yeah. You know, I'm enjoying it.
The MVP car is a tradition as old as the Super Bowl itself.
Sharp looks, has time, throws in the end zone, great catch.
Bart, it's a real pleasure to present you keys to this car.
Since Bart Starr received a Corvette after Super Bowl I, the makes and models have changed. In fact, style is the reason many trade their gift lift back in.
Buick was the sponsor. I got a Buick.
It's nerve-wracking for me, you know? I'm going to lose my image.
I traded it for a big black truck.
How about that, huh?
How's that?
That's not bad.
Of all the MVPs to swap out their swagmobile, perhaps only one asked for something a little less sporty.
Instead of getting a Dodge Charger, I asked him for a station wagon. Old Staubach, he must be a lot of fun. Well, yeah, we had three kids. I didn't need a Dodge Charger.
Roger Staubach's free ride came along just at the right time, as did Kurt Warner's.
It's pretty cool, especially for me at the time, because, you know, my second year in the league and playing for league minimum, I had struggled and driven so many different kinds of cars. And then to have somebody come and say, hey, we're going to give you a car, it was the coolest thing. I mean, it was nicer than the apartment that we were living in at the time. You know, it was fully loaded, had the TV in the back. I mean, my kids were loving it. You know, they just wanted to go out and drive to the convenience store so they could watch a movie on the back.
The MVP who preceded Warner had an experience far less memorable.
A year had gone by, and I actually forgot about the fact that I'd won a car. Kurt Warner was the MVP the following year, and I'm reading in the paper after the Super Bowl, and I saw that Kurt Warner had picked out some kind of truck from Ford. I looked at it, I said, dang, I guess I forgot to get my truck. So needless to say, Ford had my truck here about 4 days later.
John Elway's car was worth the wait.
Got some keys for you, Hines.
Hines Ward's, not so much.
I got a nice truck. I was ecstatic about it. Next thing you know, about a couple of days later, check engine light came on, and I was like, oh man, what happened? Take it into the shop, I get it back next week. They said it was just some mechanical things, and just so happened that day it was raining, and I turned my windshield wiper on. My windshield wiper flicks off, so I think I got a lemon. I no longer have it.
There is one former MVP who will never wave goodbye to his wheels.
That truck still sits in my driveway right now. White Denali. That truck meant a lot to me because it's a reflection of all of the raw emotions that was going on.
Ray Lewis made the play. He deflected it up in the air, and Jamie Sharper picked it off.
The moment you see it, takes you right back to those raw emotions. That's why that truck will be with me forever.
I got something for you. I got some keys right here.
Each year, a new MVP will receive Pro Football's ultimate freebie and no doubt be delighted.
It's your car. I got a car? Do I really? Oh. I get a car.
The MVP car, a tradition that goes hand in hand with the Super Bowl.